Hi, welcome to Music and Mind. My name's Deanne Hunt. I'll be here weekly to introduce you to some of our area's most talented and insightful musicians and luminaries. Join us here each week on Channel 23 or on YouTube at Music and Mind anytime to gain an inside view of our local luminaries. Hope to see you soon. Hi, I'm Dan Hunt. Welcome to Music in Mind, our debut, so to speak. Our guest today is Mr. Mark Burton, who I've had the pleasure of hearing perform at Fast Eddie's in New Milford, I believe, and also at Molten Java. So we're going to give you a taste of Mark's music right off the bat. So Mark, though you're tethered to your lavalier, I don't know if you have enough room to do that. So how do we do that?
So sorry. Your vocabulary just killed me, man.
What do you want to do? Do you want to just give me your history?
Yeah.
How about talk a little bit about what inspired you? What got you going into this?
It all started when I was 8. My parents got divorced, and my mom left her guitar in the closet.
Yeah.
And I went in there, and I played with it, and I kind of realized at that moment, like, I always wanted a guitar, and one day she came back and took it with her, so for years I've been asking my dad to buy one for me, and when I turned 11, he actually got me an electric guitar, and I played every day for about 4 hours, didn't do my homework, didn't hang out with my friends, I was obsessed with it, and I started a band around that time. Short-lived. I wanted to learn how to play other instruments as well. And then, you know, I've just been writing music ever since, all original music. I don't really play covers. It's not my thing. And I try to write music that inspires people to, you know, enjoy life in a whole different angle. You know, like a happy person could hear a sad song and make them much more grateful for what they have. And it's the other way around, too. A sad person can hear something that I've written that's sad and be like, wow, my life could have been so much worse. So the energy I'm trying to project behind my music is actually just love and understanding.
I can feel that, you know, and that's one of the reasons why I wanted to have you on as a guest, because I'm from the same place. The music that's inspired me the most in my life is stuff like yours, you know, the folk, the stuff that comes straight from the heart. And you got it, man. I mean, it's right there. Did you have any specific musical influences that...
Like other bands and stuff?
Yeah.
Well, I used to be really big on punk rock. And then over time, I started becoming more interested in stuff that makes me feel relaxed, because I had a very stressful life growing up. And I started listening to groups like Iron and Wine and Angels and Airwaves, just stuff that you don't really hear on the radio. And I also try coming up with my own inspirations from pieces of myself, feelings that I've had that, you know, you play an instrument a certain way and someone can be like, wow, I actually know how that sound makes me feel.
Great. So. Great. We want to give people a taste of what Mark sounds like. We're going to focus on me for a while so he has a chance to take his lavalier off so that he can go over there and perform. So if you could do that while we're talking. Just briefly, this is an introductory show, or debut, as I said. So it's going to be, hopefully, on weekend. We're doing a preliminary session first. And Mark's getting ready now to do a tune, so I'm going to turn it over to him. Mark Burton.
I just wanted to say thank you for putting me on the show, Dan. It means a lot. Yeah. I'm going to play one of my most popular songs. I wrote this about 2 years ago, and supposedly the number 4 projects positive energy, so I wrote a song about that. So here it goes.
Yeah.
Talk for a spell, and we'll get back and give the audience a little more of that. Just put your lamp on here shortly.
Back on.
Yeah, right there. Got it?
Okay.
Man, it's, you know, that stuff is just beautiful. You know, I don't know. I know for me that when something, the muse just, I get out of the way, you know. The music takes me so far away. Does it feel the same way to you when you write your best stuff?
What I write isn't really for me, it's actually for everyone else, and I kind of want them to feel what I felt when I wrote that song. That song has got quite an interesting history behind it.
I guess it does.
Yeah.
From what I recall. I had no idea that you were the original writer of that, but that's great. It's a beauty.
Thanks, Dan.
So where do you like to play in the area?
Well, I'm kind of on unemployment right now. I hurt my back, but I can still play music. I go to 5 open mics a week. You know, I make a lot of friends there, and a lot of people like collaborating with me there, you know, not outside of there, but background vocals, whatever. On Sundays, I go to Widow Brown's in Danbury. Monday, sometimes I go to Billy Bean's in Danbury. Tuesday, I go to O'Connor's in Brookfield. Wednesday, I go to O'Connor's in New Milford. And on Thursdays, I go to Fast Eddie's, where you've been taping me. So.
Right, yeah. Yeah, like I said, you know, it's just amazing stuff. But, trying to think of something that the correlation between you and, I mean, we had some synchronicity with the train stuff going on, and this happens to be right next to a railroad track.
Yeah, that is pretty ironic.
Yeah.
You're talking about that song that you showed me that you wrote.
Yes.
Well, I guess what really connects you and me is last summer I've been married. I had a wife, and it didn't work out. So I wrote a song about it called Let You Go. It was 6 minutes long. And the whole time that I wrote this song, it was very, out of the mind. It was kind of haunting. I thought of myself just walking on a railroad train or a railroad in the middle of the night, kind of like trying to find myself because I just lost somebody who was such a big part of me. And and then you showed me that song and you told me what it was about. I saw what it was about. I actually I covered it for you a few times because I loved it. And that's what I see as a huge connection, is we both kind of have the same train of thought.
Yes.
So.
Indeed. Let's see, we probably have enough for what, at least two or three more songs. You got a couple you can do?
If you'd like me to, I'd love to.
I think the audience would love it, huh?
Okay.
Please. Mr. Mark Burton, part two.
This one is it's called Amazing Woman. This is actually Dan's favorite song that I've written, so I'm gonna play this one for him. So here it is.
Yes, you are.
play another?
Please. Couple.
I'm
couple
try
more.
Try this one. This one's for my girlfriend Sophia. She's a really good girl. And it's kind of true, everything I wrote in this one, and that's not really normally me. So here it is.
Watching the wind blowing your hair in your face. You're standing so close, you're all I see. You make me nervous, you make my heart race. You're falling into my when you're falling into my arms, and we're lying in the back of my car. It doesn't matter where we are, I'm crazy about you. Just a few more days passing by. We're falling in love so fast that we cry. Growing together, accepting our differences. We think so alike, you finish my sentences. You're falling into my heart. When you're falling into my arms, and we're lying in the back. Doesn't matter where we are, crazy about you. I'm crazy about you. I'm crazy about you. I'm crazy about you.
How about a little outro? Can you do a quick ditty for an outro for us?
Let's do another one.
Got on a boat and sailed away. But honey, you don't know I miss you every day. And even though we've gone a separate ways, if I came back, what would you say? Now I'm too far gone, so long. And everything that seemed right is wrong. But now I'm strong. I still feel the pain in my heart. The thoughts never run nor ever start. You never seem near or too far. Whether I take a train, a bus, or a car. Now I'm too far gone, so long. And everything that seems that is wrong, but now I'm strong. Got on a boat and sailed away. But honey, you don't know I miss you every day. And even though we've gone our separate ways, if I came back, what would you say? Now I'm too far gone, so long. And everything that seems that is wrong, but now I'm strong. And if you ever hear this song and you sing along, know I love you. No, I love you, yeah. No, I love you. No, I love you, yeah. No, I love you. No, I love you.
Beautiful, beautiful, Mark. Beautiful. Just have a seat for a minute and let the people know that where you'll be playing next. Yes, well, we have to get your mic to it.
What day is it? Tuesday? There's a chance.
Just hold it.
The answer here.
I'll probably be playing at O'Connor's tomorrow, Wednesday, in New Milford.
Good.
And then Thursday I'll be at Fast Eddie's.
Mm-hmm. I'll be there.
It just seems like a lot of people are begging me to go to these open mics now.
I can see why. It's such beautiful stuff.
Yeah, so I'm going to try to be very humble about it. I'm trying to deliver a message, and that's about it, you know?
Mm-hmm. You do it very well.
Thank you.
thanks for being my first guest on the show.
You're welcome. And
I'd like to thank the audience for also watching, and hope you'll come back to see us next week or whenever it is. Mark, again.
Thanks for coming.
Just thank you, Dan.
Sit a spell and we'll sit and chat.
Okay. Sounds
good. Let the audience take us out. Thanks for joining us. We'll see you hopefully the next time we are on. Thanks. Music's Mine, Dan Hunt speaking. And Mark Burton, our untongue-twisted guest. Thanks.
You're welcome, Dan.
Thanks.